good day. Actually, today's a great day because I'll be building out my 4-inch micro FPV drone, and I get to introduce you to the new frame I've designed for this build, the Cobra. That's right, we've got a new addition to our venomous snake frame family to go along with our diamondback rattler hybrid frame and our pygmy rattler 3-inch micro FPV drone frame you can also check out on the pilot stem page at tmacfpv.com. I'll go over some of the unique design features of this 4-inch micro FPV drone frame, which make it stand out from others and ideal for extended or micro long-range FPV flights. It's both lightweight and durable, able to support both digital and analog FPV video systems, and just about any 20x20 or all-in-one flight control stack combination out there without the need for 3D printed adapters. I'll quickly show you how to assemble it, then I'll build out our first micro FPV Cobra drone frame kit and take her out for a spin. Sound good? Then make sure to give this video a thumbs up below and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff. Here's what comes in the Cobra 4-inch micro FPV drone frame kit. Following in the traditions of both the Diamondback and Pygmy Rattler frames, one of the beautiful things about the Cobra frame kit is its simplicity. You've got the base plate, the top plate, 6 25mm knurled standoffs, M2 screws, and the same custom 3D printed micro FPV camera mount that comes with both the Diamondback and the Pygmy Rattler frames. In fact, it's interchangeable between all three frames. Why did I choose to go with the same design for the camera mount? That's simple. It works really well. All right, let me quickly go over some of the unique features I've designed into this frame, and then I'll quickly put it together to show you how simple it is. Then we'll get started with our build. There are a few distinguishing characteristics of our Cobra micro FPV 4-inch drone frame. First, there's the Cobra type hood at the front. Besides its menacing look, it actually has a purpose, along with the dual strut arms to provide both durability and extra space for additional mounting patterns. I'll explain here in a bit. For additional durability at the rear arms, you'll notice the width of the arms is not constant. Instead of additional braces between the front and back arms, or between the back arms themselves, which also makes the quad heavier, I chose to taper the rear arms from where they connect to the main plate at 25mm width down to 8mm width at the motor pads, which is the exact same width of the arms on both the Pygmy and the Diamondback Rattler frames. By the way, the second batch of the Diamondback Rattler frame has sold out, so thanks to all of our new Rattler pilots. These two features of both the front arms and the rear arms means they're both quite durable. At the motor pads, you'll notice the motor mounting pattern has slots that support both 9mm and 12mm motor mounting patterns. On both the front and the back motors, you have these small protrusions which extend forward and to the side on the front pads and to the rear and the side on the back pads. These are there to provide additional protection to your motors that have an outside motor belt diameter of 24mm or less. For comparison purposes, the Hyperlite 1804.5 outside motor belt diameter is just under 23mm, and the Airblade UAV Superman 1606 outside motor belt diameter is 22mm. Both the top and the bottom plates have strategically placed Cobra marking band cutouts, which increase airflow and keep your electronic components at a cooler operating temperature while maintaining both strength and durability. You can see here at the bottom plate, it's a dual stack frame and can support a lot of different mounting patterns. Of course, you can have your normal 20x20 stacks front and back, or you can have a 20x20 stack in one position and an all-in-one board at the other, and it doesn't matter which one you have in which position. Or you can even have two all-in-one boards, one at the front position and another all-in-one board at the rear position. These can either be mounted the traditional diagonal method, or you also have the option to mount the front all-in-one board oriented the same way as a regular 20x20 stack. All of this can be accomplished without any additional 3D mount adapters. This means with all of these different mounting positions, you're able to choose what components you want in your build and not be limited by your drone frame. You can place a Cadex Vista or a Shark Bite system up front if you'd like, run an analog split type camera up front, such as the Runcam Split or Hybrid or a Cadex Tarsier, or simply split your traditional 20x20 stacks between the two mounting positions as I did on my latest Rattler Extended Flight XF build. The bottom line is, it's your choice. If you're not yet familiar with this 3D printed camera mount, it's got three different positions to mount your camera so you can adjust it forward or backward as needed. The mount itself is 15 millimeters tall, and since the Cobra comes with 25 millimeter standoffs, this means you can adjust your camera vertically up and down if you'd like. Speaking of standoffs, this Cobra frame has a variable height top plate, which means you can adjust it downward for a slammed Cobra simply by using shorter standoffs. There's nothing keeping you from doing so. In fact, if you want, and you put in your special instructions that you'd like the 20 millimeter standoffs as opposed to the 25 millimeter standoffs, I can ship the Cobra frame out with the 20 millimeter standoffs. If I don't get any special instructions, it'll go out with the standard 25 millimeter standoffs. If for some reason you don't want to use the 3D printed camera mount, or if you happen to misplace yours, these slots in the bottom of the base plate here allow you to install one of those metal bracket camera mounts that come with a lot of your FPV cameras for free. It just sits on here like this. Of course, you can fly the Cobra as a bottom or top mount battery, and if you go with a top mount, you've got these four Cobra snake scales. You can slide your battery strap in between. Keep it in place. As I mentioned, the Cobra flies a max 4-inch prop, and even with those, it's got a 160-degree field of view with no props in view of your camera. Its diagonal motor-to-motor distance is 178.7 millimeters. The front-to-front and rear-to-rear motor distances is 142.5 millimeters. And the front-to-rear motor-to-motor distance is 108 millimeters. The top plate is 1.5 millimeters, the same as the Diatone Roma 4, Explorer LR, and our Pygmy Rattler. The bottom plate is 2.5 millimeters, the same as our Diamondback Rattler. All right, let's see how easy this is to assemble. I'll start with the tough part, which is the micro camera mount. Take one of the 25 millimeter standoffs, and we insert the end of the standoff into the hole of the 3D printed micro FPV camera mount, and we push it in. We get it started by pushing it in. Now, these are pressure fit so that the camera mount won't slide up and down or wobble around on the standoffs. That's what's going to give you some stable FPV video. So once you've started it in there like that, what I like to do is take a cloth and wrap it around the standoff like that, then take a pair of pliers or something that you have around here and grab it, and then twist the camera mount onto the standoff until it comes out the other end, like that. And you could adjust how high or low you want the camera mount on the standoff, obviously. And then you just repeat the process for the other end and the other micro FPV 3D printed camera mount. And you end up with something like this. Once you've got the standoffs in the micro FPV camera mount, you're ready to assemble the frame. We've got these M2 screws over here, so we just grab some of these, go one at a time. We've got six screws at the bottom. Now these back screws go in these holes all the way at the back. Place the top plate on. And we got six screws up top. And I usually throw in a couple extra screws so that you can mount your camera on the camera mount. That's it. We're done. That's how simple it is. If you need to work on your quad, all you have to do is take these six screws out, remove the top plate. You've got full access to your electronic components. Now, normally these 4-inch frames have been weighing in at between 40 to 50 grams. What's your guess? How about 36.5 grams?
Oh,
insert that in your all-up weight calculator you can grab on the Build Your Own Micro FPV Drone page at tmacfpv.com, and you're well on your way to a sub-250G all-up weight Micro FPV drone build. All right, these are the components I'll be using. I've listed them here with their weights on the screen as well in the all-up weight calculator, which you can grab through a link in the video description below. So my planned build all-up weight, if I've got a good estimate, should come in under 250 grams. I've got the Flywoo Goku GN745 all-in-one flight controller. If you're not familiar with this flight controller, I encourage you to check out this video. I'll be using the SharkBite digital system to include the TX-S 5.1 video transmitter, which comes in a whoopboard type mounting pattern of 25.5 by 25.5. This will sit nicely in our Cobra's front stack position. With the Cobra's versatile mounting positions, although the VTX comes with this mount adapter, we won't be needing this. So by not using this, we're actually saving about 2.5 grams. I'll also be using the Foxeer Digisight analog and digital camera. Normally for an extended flight build for endurance or longer range, I'd be using these Airblade Dark Knight 1404 2500 kV motors, which now come with both a 9x9 and 12x12mm mounting pattern. That means you can now use these on the 3mm baseplate Diamondback Rattler, which comes with a 12mm mounting pattern. These are the most efficient motors I've come across for extended flights on 4S. Since I've already got them on three of my builds, I've decided to try a different setup with these Brother Hobby 1504.5 2950 kV motors. Now by doing that, I'm also increasing the weight by about 8 grams over what it would be with the Airblade 1404s. But I'm willing to give these a shot. I'll be using my normal TBS Crossfire Nano receiver, either with the TBS Immortal T antenna that weighs about 3.4 grams, or if I wanted to save a couple grams and have cross-polarization, I could go with the Video Aerial Systems, or VAS, X-Fire Pro antenna. I'll also install a self-powered Lucky Box buzzer and a Maytek SAM M8Q GPS module. I'll provide links to all the components I'll be using in the video description below if you're interested. Okay, let's build our Cobra. Now we're ready to weigh our Cobra in. Any guesses? I think our estimate was around 243 all-up weight, which with this 4S 1100 milliamp hour GNB LiPo to include the Velcro that I normally place on it, that comes in at 90.5 grams. So that would mean without the battery, our estimate for the dry weight would be around 153. Let's see how close we were. Let's make sure and get it all on the scale. ...147! With the GNB 4S 1100 milliamp hour LiPo? 237.7. We're good to go.
All right, that was fun. Let me know what you think of the Cobra. Thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.